Hello and welcome. Aaron Knight here. Today we are going to talk about five quality of life items that I hope to see in Destiny 2. We've gotten so much depth and hobbyist level stuff back in Destiny 2 with the launch of Forsaken. I'm having so much fun right now. I feel like there's always something to do. Sometimes it feels a bit overwhelming, but I'm okay with that. Totally fine. We're gonna, you know, I'm learning in this first season of Forsaken. I feel like I have so much to do, and I don't know if I'm gonna have time to get it done. But as the season kind of plays out, and we're now into November, I do feel like I'm knocking out my stuff, and you know, we'll be ready for Black Armory and you know, future DLC or expansions as the seasons come to a close. But anyways. Back to today's video topic, five quality of life items that I hope to see in Destiny 2. With this, there's usually always quality of life items that as guardians who play the game a lot, we notice this stuff. It, as good as the game can possibly be, as good as it is right now, at least for me, and you know, Cyborg, we do a podcast every week. I'm sure many of you play a lot. We still notice things about the game that would be nice if we're tweaked a little bit, or if we had just this little thing. Sometimes maybe it's something we had before, sometimes maybe not. But you know, that's part of it. That's part of our role as the end user, the player, to convey that to Bungie. So I'm not saying these things are the most important things, but they are items, again, that I've noticed during my play sessions and that I think would add even more depth and fun to our experience playing Destiny. So these are in no particular order. So you guys, let me know down below any others you have. I'm sure there are many, many more, many that are important to you. But definitely let me know. Let me know what you think about the ones that I mentioned here. Definitely want to hear all your thoughts and opinions. With that, number one, vendor weekly inventory rotation, especially with random rolls back in the game. Now, what I'm talking about is something we've just gotten back, actually, in Destiny 2. This is something I believe reset every week on the weekly reset in Destiny 1, which was so cool because it gave us a reason to log in and go look at rolls. Of course, random rolls went away with the launch of D2, but once they came back, before they came back, we started to get vendor rotation of a weapon sold and some armor, I believe. Of course, there weren't random rolls or random perks on that gear, that loot, but how nice would it be? It would be great to have it weekly, but even once a month, weekly reset makes more sense. Even if it was one weapon and one armor piece that was randomly rolled each reset, that we could go check and see if it's that roll. We can't get that roll to drop, but maybe the vendor will sell it at some point. So this is a primary example of a quality of life item that I would like to see come back in Destiny 2. Anyways, let me know what you guys think about that one. Moving on, re-rolling the Masterwork stat bonus on your gear. Specifically weapons. I think it would work for either, of course, but specifically thinking weapons. Man, there's so much, there's such a dice roll on the weapon roll hunt. And I'm going to say this. I absolutely love that random rolls are back. I in no way, shape, or form want to be able to re-roll the main perks on my weapon. I think when that came out and with House of Wolves, while it was super fun and super cool, and we could get that roll eventually we wanted if we had the materials to do it, ultimately, I don't think it was the best for the game. Everyone just hunted down the one or two rolls that you should get, and that's all you saw in the Crucible. I think it's fun to have random rolls on the base perks. It makes you go play activities. It makes you hunt. It makes you excited when you get another drop. But the Masterwork stat, that's another layer of randomness. While I do like that additional layer of randomness, I think it would be super fun to be able to reroll that Masterwork stat like we could do back in year one. One main reason. Rerolling was a lot of fun. It was super fun. It kind of broke the game. You know, a lot of Guardians thought that, and I'm one of them. It kind of broke the game a little bit, broke the meta. So you can get a little bit of it, a little bit of that fun if you could reroll your Masterwork stat. I think it would be super cool. I think it should be costly. I don't think it should be cheap, but it would be awesome. You finally get your roll you want, and then maybe if the Masterwork stat isn't quite the one you wanted, or at least you think you wanted, then boom, reroll if you got the materials. Again, make it costly. Make it a decision. And then you know, you can test different Masterwork stats out as well, you know, just to see if you want handling or stability or whatever on something. Some weapon archetypes are more specific and you kind of know what you want. Others aren't. You want to try different things out. That's number two. Let me know what you guys think about that one. Next up, exotic armor perk rerolling. Okay, we just got done talking about how I don't want to be able to reroll the main perks on a weapon or your armor. I didn't say armor, but I am saying armor too when it comes to legendary. Now, I have asked some people different things out on Twitter, like you've probably seen me do. And I recently, I think I've seen this before, and even another person, the Dirt Fam or Twitter user, sent back to me, loved this idea. The idea was exotic armor rerolling. Exotic armor having random rolls is absolutely fantastic. It's so cool. Again, adds more depth to the game. But the thing is it's your exotic armor piece. Like, once you get it, it's part of your loadout. Like, I use Syntheseps on PvP. I have hand cannon loader and shotgun, I think special ammo finder. Of course, doesn't do anything for PvP. So I think this could add, kind of like the Masterwork reroll, just that little bit of fun rerolling excitement to the game. If we could reroll just exotic armor, okay? Because obviously exotic weapons are locked in. Just exotic armor. If we could reroll that, and the example the Twitter user, again, sorry, I believe it was a Dirt Fam member. This was just like last week. Glass needles, remember those? They mentioned those. How cool would it see? We don't necessarily need another infusion material. It could just be enhancement cores as we know them now. That's kind of tied to legendary, but you can even tie Xur into this. I hope at some point to release a Xur video, give Xur some love. You could reintroduce glass needles to Xur. You get them from Xur. I don't know, just brainstorming here. Let me know what you guys think. Could you intertwine Xur into this? But make it costly. But it would be so cool to be able to reroll and specify it for your build. Like right now, I would reroll my Syntheseps probably multiple times until I got my hand cannon shotgun loadout set with my Syntheseps. So again, I think this could be really cool. Add that little bit of rerolling, but not break the game. Just exotic armor, just Masterwork stat. So I don't know, just an idea. Again, let me know what you guys think on that one. Number four, direct paths to acquire mod components. I've mentioned this one on the show, Destiny Reset. You guys hopefully listen to that. If not, check out Destiny Reset podcast. But I really need mod components. Now, I'm going to clarify. I love that mods are expensive. I love that it's a decision when I input one into my weapon or my armor. I have six mod components, and I think I've had six or less for the last two or three weeks. Granted, I'm not farming. I'm not doing any of the farming methods that I've saw or heard about. But I shouldn't have to do that, right? It's one thing to go out and farm planetary materials. Mod components is something you should kind of acquire as you play the game, dismantling legendaries. Maybe increase the drop there. We've seen Masterwork cores or enhancement cores get the love. They've got bounties at the Spider now, at Spider, where you can get enhancement cores. Those are still, I think, need a little bit of tweaking, but this is exactly what we need. My buddy Cool Guy, I Am Cool Guy, if you haven't checked out his YouTube channel, he released a video on the gunsmith and what we could do to show the gunsmith some love. And an example was bounties that allowed you to get mod components. So I love that idea. More direct ways to get mod components. Make it still expensive to buy them, or because of that, a big decision on what gun you put them in. I love that. Absolutely love that. But I would like to be able to acquire more than one or two, or come across more than one or two a reset, with them costing 10 to get one. I wanted the miner spec the other day because I want that in my PvE auto rifle, and I couldn't get it. I could have went and farmed, sure. I had other things on my to-do list. It would just be nice if you got more of them while you naturally play the game, is basically what I'm saying. So I'm sure they'll show some love to my components. Enhancement cores or Masterwork cores was first on the list. Let me know what you guys think on that one. Are you coming across mod components? How are your enhancement cores doing since they made the change? Next up, crucial vendor bounties and all items like that located in the tower. So what I'm talking about here is a lot of people are saying they want to be able to pick up bounties on their app. I think that's cool. I think that could work. I would probably be fine with that. But I'll tell you what, when I log on, I like to go to the tower first. I like to go to the tower, get all my bounties, do all that stuff, prep for whatever I'm going to do for the night, and then go start. I don't know what it is. I like to do that. I do that usually when I log on, and I do that when I log off. So, and we'll get into that log off party with Ingrams here in a minute with an honorable mention. Anyways, that is what I like to do. So I get, you know, it's loading in, it's time that you could be playing. It'd be cool. Yes, it'd be cool to be able to get this stuff on your app. But what I'm talking about specifically is, let's say we don't get something on the app. Things that the spider has, for example, need to be at the tower. Material exchange. It'd be cool if it wasn't rotating every week and you could permanently exchange certain types of material each week. That's an example there. And then basically, obviously the spider's not going to move, but for example, the drifter in the tower, that's a great example of an activity that you're possibly going to do, and also located in the tower. The haunted forest stuff, Festival of Lost, boom, in the tower. So I think it's important going forward, specifically material exchange at spider, that really needs to be in the tower. I don't know who would be best, but it would be awesome if it was in the tower. Let me know what you guys think about that one. Okay, one that I've got to mention just real quick. They're aware of it. They know about it. Performance issues on console. I would assume it's not happening on PC, maybe a little bit, but man, loading times, I know they're working on it again, but they're atrocious. Like, I can't even go in and switch something or look at my inventory without, like, have already spawned in PvP and possibly be killed before my menu loads. Granted, I don't spend a lot of time in my menus when I'm playing PvP, but every now and then I need to go in and do something real quick. So I can only imagine, like, an encounter when you're playing PvE. So anyways, I know they've mentioned that. Hopefully we'll see that soon, but it's almost a must mention at this point. An honorable mention, I've got a few of these. I'm going to start with solo PV playlists. Just real quick, I loved in Destiny 1 how we had freelance playlists. I think it would be cool. I know splitting up the community is part of the thought here, and I don't know what all goes on behind the scenes, but man, it would be cool to be able to solo queue, at least in competitive. I know you're supposed to take your team into competitive. My playtime is so random and things of that nature that I play a lot solo. So I'm a big PvP player and I want those PvP rewards. Yes, I do coordinate and get my fire team together sometimes throughout the week, but I also have to try and solo a lot of things. So I am glad they let me solo queue in competitive, but man, it would be so cool to have some sort of freelance way to do that like we used to back in D1. So again, I don't know how that would split the community. Maybe that's why we don't want to do that. We don't want to split the playlists up too much and thin the pool of Guardians that are playing. I'm sure there's way more to this. Again, it's an honorable mention. It's just something I did want to throw in there because I did enjoy the freelance playlist we had back in Destiny 1. The other honorable mention, PvP rank more easily viewable on the players you're playing with. Now, maybe part of this is they don't want people to see other people's ranks without having the emblem on. But I think it would be cool, like in my fire team, I always want to go see what my friends are, see what the Dirt fan members are, whoever. Like, what rank are you at? So I asked them. I think it would be cool if you could see their rank, just like I can see mine. It'd be cool if they had like a little note, not necessarily on their emblem. I know you can throw the emblem on, but if they don't have the emblem on, if we're playing competitive or quick play, it'd be cool to see the little icon next to their name or their title emblem outside of that that showed their rank. I think that would be cool. Again, maybe they think it's better if people aren't able to see other people's rank that easily. It'd be cool if it was your fire team. You'd think you wouldn't care if your fire team saw your rank. I could understand maybe opposing Guardians. It's your choice to put the emblem on or not. But that's one that I think would be cool and be a little bit more player friendly. Okay, final honorable mention. You guys have probably heard me say this before, especially if you've listened to the show, Cryptarch Ingram decoding. Now, this one is definitely important to me, but I found a little bit of a happy ground on this one, okay? When Forsaken first launched, we quickly realized that Prime Ingrams were the only thing that you took to the Cryptarch. And part of my logging off fun every night was I took all the Ingrams I got and I went to Raul and I decoded them all. Super fun. It was just fun to do that right before I logged off and went to bed and crashed for the night. And when Forsaken dropped, I realized auto decode began. And we can still have the Prime Ingrams. But, and I do, I have learned to love the auto-decode. It is cool, I do like it, it's instant gratification, I know a lot of Guardians like that, but for me, I still love to have that little loot opening extravaganza whenever I logged off each night. So, I kind of thought of a happy medium. I think a happy medium would be if you made exotic Ingrams still require the Cryptarch to decode. Granted, an exotic Ingram drop rate is pretty rare, so it's not like it's going to add that much. But even if they were buffed a little, even if they dropped a little bit more, you may have one or two primes and maybe one exotic to take to Raul, maybe every two play sessions. I don't know. I just missed the days of visiting the tower before I logged off, had my decoding loot party, chatted with my friends, saw what I got, and the big kicker, the reason I was so excited when Forsaken dropped to get these engrams, it makes every engram exciting, almost every one of them that you get out in the wild, no matter what you're doing, because random rolls are back. And I was so excited to go to Raul and open all this stuff, you know? So I've heard you Guardians that love the auto decode. Many of you prefer that. I just miss going to see good old Raul before I log off and decoding my engrams. But with that, that's something I kind of miss. So I think maybe there's a happy medium in there somewhere. Okay, those are my top five plus honorable mentions plus a much must mention. Let me know what you guys think. Again, like what are your thoughts on my five items? What has your experience been like playing since Forsaken? And have you thought of, or do you have any quality of life items on your own list that you'd like to see implemented into the game? Be sure to comment below. Let me know what your thoughts are, or anything else we talked about in this video. So really excited and looking forward to hearing what you guys think on mine and some you have of your own. Also, what's your favorite thing to do in Destiny right now? What are you guys doing? I got my EP Shoddy last week, and now I am on Full Force Hunt. I'm on the last step of getting my Lunas Howl, and that is what I'm focusing on. I may kind of throw like a little what have I been doing this reset at the end of my video. So that's what I've been doing right now. What have you guys been doing this reset? Be sure and let me know below. Also, of course, don't hesitate to send me any other topics you'd like to see me cover. As you know, I post a lot of LiveCom videos, and I usually throw up like a tweet or something to vote on the loadout that I'm going to use. So definitely check out my Twitter feed. Let me know what loadouts you'd like to see, what you're using. I'm always playing and always excited to throw up anything you guys would be interested in. So, of course, thank you all so much for tuning in. If you enjoyed this video, a like is very much appreciated. If you would enjoy watching more of my content, be sure and subscribe to my channel and hit that bell down below to get immediate notification when new content goes live. You can find all my info and links below, as well as links for our podcast, Destiny Reset, which we release every Monday. You can find me on Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, all the things, at Aeronight with a zero, AerKnight. I look forward to chatting with you all, and until next time, take care.